American multinational company Avaya Holdings moves swiftly to enable companies, schools, governments, and organizations of all kinds to adapt to working from anywhere. With us now for more is Sammi Ammous, Avaya ASEAN Managing Director in Singapore. Avaya Philippines is a subsidiary of Avaya US, but is also registered as a local Philippine company. Good to see you, Sammi. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Katie.
Yeah, thank you. Enable remote working forces on a global scale. How have you helped your Philippine customers with business continuity, transitioning workers to work from anywhere environments during the enhanced community quarantine?
Well, as you well know, that the BPO industry is one of the larger industries in the Philippines, and we've been very fortunate given the opportunity to actually enable those companies to continue working business as usual to support their customers around the world. In simple terms, what we're doing is we're allowing agents to use our software and our tools to log in using any PC or even mobile phone anywhere in the country that has internet access to be able to receive calls and serve end customers. So for us, it's an opportunity to do, I'm going to use some jargon, a win-win situation where we help the BPOs and they also rely on our technology to serve their end customers.
Yeah, but how did you manage the sudden spike in demand for remote worker solutions, especially as the enhanced community quarantine kicked in here in the Philippines and then a directive of work from home ensued?
So we have a couple of things that work in our favor. The first area is, as a company, we use these tools and we've used them for many years. So we actually know what it takes for a remote worker to actually operate, whether it's the infrastructure tools, whether it's the software, whether it's the headsets like the one I'm using right now. So as best practice, as just how to actually manage a business where your employees are working remotely, we managed to help our customers think about those items to be able to ramp up quickly. The second area is, as I mentioned earlier, because the Philippines is such a big BPO market for us, we actually have large amounts of stock, whether it's headsets, whether it's phone sets, whether it's other collaboration devices like what we call huddle cameras, which allow people to work wherever they want and ramp up quickly. The third area that we did was actually an international response that the company did, where we've offered free licenses for up to 90 days for all of our customers to enable their staff to work remotely. So no questions asked, you get the licenses immediately, you don't have to pay anything to Avaya for 90 days, and we still have the offer available. So that really helped us ramp up quickly, serve our customers, and make sure they're successful in this crisis.
Now, to your point on the BPO market here in the Philippines, what situation did you face when suddenly they needed your help in working from home or working remotely?
Believe it or not, the most basic thing that we faced is just the physical lockdown of the streets. So the challenge we had is just physically moving headsets and phones and devices from one part of the country to the other. The fact that they're BPOs and they're used to working internationally and using things like remote access and using the internet allowed us to configure and deliver our licenses remotely very quickly. The act of physically moving devices was the biggest challenge we had. Luckily, the BPO industry was one of the ones that had a bit of an exception in terms of the ability to move and ability for staff to actually go to their offices, and that exception helped us deliver these items in a timely manner.
Yeah, that must have been a logistical challenge. Sammi, I know that you're currently talking to clients about what they think will be the new normal. You've checked out the business process outsourcing as well as the banking industry. So what did they come back with? What feedback when it comes to secured communications and services?
So I think the first 1 or 2 weeks has been somewhat of a scramble to figure out what the directives mean and how companies can quickly adapt to that. And now, as you said, they're coming to the realization that this might be the new normal. But what do we mean by that? Even with the relaxation of the lockdown or any sort of restriction, I think what will happen is a more acceptance of what we call remote working. And that means that companies don't have to physically see staff. There's a more sense of trust in that people will do their work regardless of where they sit. And we've done some studies before on remote working, and we found that remote workers actually become more productive, of course, provided that they have the right environment to work. So I think part of the new norm is a more trust in employees, more flexibility in terms of where to work, And if you look at the broader implications, it might even be that some companies by design expect some of their staff to continue working remotely, and thus they might reduce their real estate costs, they might reduce their transportation costs. So the implications of this are still to be seen.
Indeed,
even on a personal level, sorry, Katie, but even on a personal level, things like travel, we're expected historically to fly around the ASEAN region as business leaders. But now I think customers are starting to see that remote video conferencing is not the end of the world. You can actually get business done using video conferencing.
Exactly what we're doing right now and having this conversation. So how are the preliminary results of those you've been speaking with? How are they going to influence the way that you serve your customers in this new normal?
You know, in a way, it's positive for a company like Avaya because we provide this solution infrastructure. But also at the same time, I think the adjustments that need to take place are not necessarily around technology, but it's around the processes. So a simple example, I'm working at home. I'm fortunate in that I have a space where I can claim as my office space, good background, good light, so I can do interviews like this and not be bothered. But even within running business calls for my own team, you have children running, yelling, you have pets running around, deliveries, doorbells ringing. So when you live at home and you work from home, it's a bit different, and those challenges need to come into play when you're thinking about this. The other area that needs to be taken into account is how companies actually manage their staff. It used to be that you clock in, you clock out, which was an easy way to make sure that people are in the office and working. But then maybe when staff become remote, you need to look at different measures. Maybe you need to measure productivity versus time or hours spent. Maybe the relationship between staff and employees, between staff and employers, becomes more about productivity and MBOs versus the classic model of just looking at hours spent in the office.
What about for e-learning? Just as a final point, I know that you're finalizing the launch of your video collab product, Avaya Spaces, here in the Philippines. What does this do helping secure e-learning?
You know, it's interesting. I'll share an anecdotal story from my friends who have their kids working, studying from home now. And they're saying that they have been pleasantly surprised in how well the kids have adapted to working remotely or learning remotely. And I think the secret is, especially today's kids, they've been brought up in an environment that's slightly different than the way we grew up. They're comfortable working remotely with their friends or playing on things like any sort of the online games, where so they're comfortable to just chatting, to doing things over video. The school curriculums actually have adapted quite quickly to remote learning. So I believe that it could be a viable solution for a bit longer than the current situation demands. Obviously, some things can't be replaced by remote learning. Once you get to physics labs, chemistry labs, opportunities where you have to physically interact with other students or your classmates. But I think in the short term, it will prove to be a viable solution, at least as a stopgap until a longer term solution comes into play or the virus is brought under control.
Right, a lot of changing that needs to be done. The new normal, as they say, across all industries. Thank you so much for providing us a look-see into the future.
Absolute pleasure.
Sammi Ammous, the ASEAN Managing Director of Avaya.